gather here at St. Joseph's as we celebrate the 14th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Please stand as you're able.
Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary, the Virgin, God, who the abasement of your Son have raised up a fallen world, fill your faithful with holy joy. For on those you have rescued from slavery to sin, you bestow eternal gladness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Zechariah. Thus says the Lord, rejoice heartily, O daughter of Zion. Shout for joy, O daughter of Jerusalem. See, your king shall come to you, a just savior is he. Meek and riding on an ass, on a colt, the foal of an ass. He shall banish the chariot from Ephraim, and the horse from Jerusalem, and the warrior's bow he shall banish. And he shall proclaim peace to the nations. His dominion shall rise from the sea to sea, and from the river to the ends of the earth. The word of the Lord.
Lifting up all those who fall, God raises up.
reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, you are not in the flesh. On the contrary, you are in the Spirit, if only the Spirit of God dwells in you. Whoever does not have the Spirit of Christ does not belong to him. If the Spirit of the one who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, the one who raised Christ from the dead will give life to your mortal bodies also, through his Spirit that dwells in you. Consequently, brothers and sisters, you are not debtors to the flesh to live according to the flesh. For if you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death the deeds of the body, you will live. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I give praise to you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for although you have hidden these things from the wise and learned, you have revealed them to little ones. Yes, Father, such has been your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him. Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart, and you will find rest for yourselves, for my yoke is easy and my burden light. The Gospel of the Lord. Like many Minnesotans, I have had the joy and privilege of being able to travel to different lakes and going up to the boundary waters here in Minnesota and using the canoe on those lakes. And if you've ever been canoeing, if you've ever had to do a portage, you know how challenging it can be to transport those canoes. They are long, they are often heavy, and for us, poor teenagers at the time, we couldn't really afford the fancy lightweight ones. It's pretty awkward to move those things around. Even moving or flipping can be a pain. One of the things that makes it possible to do any kind of long distance portage or to travel or to carry that canoe from place to place is that centerpiece along the canoe, kind of on a balancing tipping point with a little notch cut out for your head and oftentimes some pads. That piece that runs across there, if you did not know, is often called the canoe yoke. It is the yoke which basically enables a person to move the canoe by themselves, to do what would almost otherwise be impossible without damaging the canoe or smashing their shins or having other difficulties. That yoke is a tool which makes something possible. And it is often the yoke that I think of when I hear Jesus speak about, take my yoke upon you and learn from me. Oftentimes, I think when people hear this, they assume that Jesus is giving them a yoke, giving them a burden, giving them a job, at times even enslaving them with something that is difficult, not possible. That's not what Jesus is trying to say at all. The yoke is a tool that makes the difficult possible, and at times even easy. When we hear yoke, we often again think that this is going to be a task or that burden is going to be something that is hard. And again, sometimes the teachings of the church, sometimes morality and doing the right thing is hard. And sometimes it can seem difficult or even almost impossible. When the Lord says, take my yoke upon you, he is saying, take these things
and see for yourselves that it makes that difficult possible. It makes what would otherwise be a burden, otherwise be a chore, otherwise be damaging or destructive into something that is easy, something that is good, something that enables us to reach our destination, to reach the goal. Like we would carry that canoe back towards the lake or back towards the truck. The yoke of our faith, the yoke of that life in Christ, is something that makes living right possible. As we gather today, we hear those words again, that his yoke is a gift for us, not a punishment, but a gift. And as we bear it, we also recognize that it is easy, and that it makes that burden light. If you ever tried again to carry something or to pull something, you realize how frustrated it can be when you can't get it to move. When you don't have the right tool for the job, it becomes frustrating, it becomes angry. Christ gives us the tools. The Eucharist, in particular, the Mass, is that greatest of tools. And it can seem, for some, I suppose, like a yoke, a burden, a task, a slavery. So we have to come each week, each Sunday, we are obligated. Does that make us slaves? No. It is that tool for the job which enables us to do what would otherwise be impossible. Because we are called to be transformed in Christ. We are called to be transformed through this gift, through this Eucharist, to be like him. As we come again today to receive Christ, to receive these gifts, these tools, which enable us to live a faithful, just life. May we entrust our lives to him. May we be thankful for that gift. May we see that his yoke truly is easy, and that burden of love becomes light. Christians throughout the world may live in the Spirit and reject all that does not come from God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That civility, mutual respect, and gentleness prevail in government and politics. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That as our nation observes Independence Day, we may work to defend our freedoms, especially the freedom of religion, and the right to live and profess our faith without fear. We pray to the Lord.
Lord.
God's grace will sustain and renew them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Regina loves Hyde, for whom this Mass is offered, and all those who have died may experience the joy of heaven, of the heavenly bouquet. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our personal intentions today, offered in silent prayer. And for all of these needs, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Gracious God and Father, we ask you to hear and answer these prayers. We ask you to trust in the holy and powerful name of Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Us with gladness. Through
Through your Son, you gather men and women whom you made for the glory of your name into one family, redeemed by the blood of his cross and signed with the seal of the Spirit. Therefore now, and for ages unending, with all the angels, we proclaim your glory, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Son of Christ, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race, and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst, when we are gathered by his love, and when, as once for the disciples sown out for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father, most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." Mystery of faith. We proclaim
your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again. We offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. By our partaking of this mystery, Almighty Father, give us life through your Spirit. Grant that we may be conformed to the image of your Son, and confirm us in the bond of communion, together with Francis, our Pope, and Donald, our Bishop, and all other bishops, the priests, and deacons, and with your entire people. Grant that all the faithful of the Church, looking into the signs of the times by the light of day, may constantly devote themselves to the service of the Gospel. Keep us attentive to the needs of all, that sharing their grief and pain, their joy and hope, we may faithfully bring them the good news of salvation and go forward with them along the way of your kingdom. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There, in community with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the apostles and martyrs, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, thank you. salvation and never cease to praise you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I want to offer a special welcome to all the members of our ACC, to all those guests who might be here today or who might be watching on the live stream. It is good that we are gathered today, and hopefully we can continue to grow together as one, and that each of our parishes might feel like your parish. The Lord be with you. Bow down and bless you. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May he let his face shine upon you and show you his mercy. May he turn his countenance towards you and give you his peace.
Amen.
May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go forth.